Congressman Peter DeFazio, not one of the guys who rolls over, is on the line with us. DeFazio for DeFazio for forcongress.org, his website. And Congressman, we've spoken before, but for people who might just be tuning in, who is Art Robinson? .com.
Well, who is Art Robinson.com? That's my opponent, who has some interesting and unusual ideas, which he denies even when you quote the things he's written back to him. He wants to abolish public education. No government funding at any level for public education. He says the free market will provide better education within 6 months for everybody. If you can't afford it, don't worry, it'll be free. I'm not quite sure where he gets that idea. He's got some very unusual ideas about the beneficial effects of radioactive waste on human life and extending our lifespan, and denies evolution, and has personally disproven global warming as a hoax to enslave the American people. That's my opponent now.
And he lives on a survivalist compound out in the woods in Oregon.
Yeah, out in the corner of Cave Junction, down in the very southwest corner of my district toward California and the Oregon coast. But, you know, you would normally think that the free press would, you know, investigate, and, you know, we would read about these things and people would say, whoa, you know, and this guy wouldn't be a factor, but there isn't much of a free press left. And beyond that, he had the help of a buddy of his from Wall Street to the tune of 8,500 points of media, which is a lot of media. 8,000, that means everybody saw, you know, these ads at least 85 times, you know, the very negative ads against me, very professionally produced. So right. It's been an interesting campaign.
Yeah, your campaign is rather the poster boy for the outcome of the Citizens United Supreme Court decision that said that corporations can, you know, can give unlimited amounts of money. They can't give it directly to the campaigns, but they can, you know, run ads and take out people or elevate people. And they've been trying to put this wackadoodle, Art Robinson, into the seat that you've been sitting in for over 20 years in the House of Representatives. You, one of them, and just because it appears, because you're one of the most progressive members of Congress, and you wanted to regulate Wall Street, so you got these Wall Street billionaires, these hedge fund guys, funding, you know, ads for this crazy guy who's running against you. That would have been a joke, were it not for Wall Street guys saying, you know, we don't like being regulated. We don't like Peter DeFazio. We're going to take him out. And
I think it goes just beyond the regulation. Remember, Tom, I advocate that people like Bob Mercer of Renaissance Technologies, a hedge fund god, should pay taxes at the same rate as other Americans, that is, in his income bracket. He doesn't. Remember, guys who manage hedge funds pay 15% because they pretend that all of the other people's money they manage is theirs, and they only earn capital gains. So an Army captain pays 25% on his income and then has to pay Social Security. So basically, the Bob Mercers of the world pay half the tax rate of average Americans. Now, that is obscene. Beyond that, we need to have a tax on speculation. 70% of what goes on Wall Street these days is ultra-high velocity or flash trading. It adds nothing except instability to the system and ill-gotten gains.
Right.
It doesn't provide long-term stable capital. I proposed reinstating a tax we had from 1916 to 1966 on speculative transactions.
Right, the step tax.
And then finally, we have the Benedict Arnold tax. You know, boys like Bob Mercer, who live in this country, enjoy the benefits of this country. Probably, I don't think he ever served in the military, but enjoys the protection of our military, our police, and everything else. Don't want to pay taxes here. So even though he pays at such a low rate, he's moved one of his hedge funds offshore to the Bahamas. It lives in a post office box over there.
Right.
And there's a tax we've proposed that would say, hey, no, you know, if you substantially operate in the U.S. and you live in the U.S., you're going to pay taxes in the United
right.
States.
So this,
if
so
you
this...
want to go live in the post office box, go live in the post office box.
Right. So this billionaire Bob Mercer is the guy who's funding Art Robinson, the wackadoodle who's running against you.
That's correct.
Or funding
that's
the campaign, the campaign.
Yeah, well,
for him.
He's funding a much better
you.
Campaign than my opponent. Yeah,
yeah.
And the ads are much better than my opponent's ads.
Yeah, well, because he's got the money to do it and do it professionally. So you see, we're talking with Congressman Peter DeFazio. His website, DeFazioForCongress.org, and get over there and check it out. This story is mind-boggling, and he can use your help. And you're suggesting that one of the remedies is to say to Justice John Roberts, sir, when you swore under oath in your confirmation hearings, well, actually, let me let you say it in your own words, What should we do about the Chief Justice of the Supreme Court?
Well, I'm going to have folks go over and review his testimony, but I have the strongest recollection that he said under oath that he would not be a judicial activist. He would observe the precedents of the court. And, you know, if you read the Justice Stevens dissent, it is the most extraordinary condemnation of an activist court I've ever read. He said they decided a case that wasn't even before them, and they invited it to be brought before them to reach a predetermined conclusion which vitiated 100 years of precedent. So if indeed Justice Roberts said unequivocally, which I recall he did, but maybe he hedged that would seem like perjury to me, and that would merit an impeachment. So we're certainly going to be pouring through. I'm asking folks to go back and review his testimony and see what kind of articles of impeachment we might be able to establish.
I am 100% in favor of that, and I would say that the same is true of Alito. And we now know, it seems that we know, this woman who has come out and given testimony to support Anita Hill, that Clarence Thomas was lying, although, like Bill Clinton, he was lying about sex and behavior rather than politics, but that he was lying during his confirmation hearings, too. So there's three potential impeachments for you, if you'd like.
I'll focus on one, head guy, the guy who really, I think, marshaled the forces to decide a case wasn't before it so he could, advantage the Republicans dramatically in this and future elections.
No, he's the Bush family guy, John Roberts. He's the guy who, in the 2000 election, when they were, going to take this thing to the Supreme Court, he was the guy who flew down to Florida and coached the legal team that was going to argue Bush v. Gore in how to argue before Rehnquist, because he used to be a clerk in Rehnquist. And, he tried to paper that over and say, oh, he just went down there for vacation for a few days. Right. So this was payback. George Bush was paying him back, and a good payback it was to become Chief Justice of the Supreme Court. In the minute we have left, Congressman Peter DeFazio, do you think that there's any chance, if the Republicans take control of the House, that any kind of impeachment, or even if they don't, could actually go forward? Or is this are you playing Don Quixote here?
Look, you got to call it the way it is. I mean, if you think that someone did not meet the obligations of their oath, both the oath they took when they became a justice and or the oath they took when they testified before the court, even if it's only one person saying it the way it is, you got to say it. I mean, if we go silent into the night, then it's going to be a really long, dark, cold night.
Yes, absolutely. And very well said. The websites, whoisartrobinson.com, do I have that right?
Mm-hmm.
And defazioforcongress.org. And you will find just an amazing story there, my friends. Check it out. Congressman Peter DeFazio, one of the really good guys in the United States House of Representatives. Thanks so much for being back with us, Congressman.
Thank you, Tom.
For audio and video archives, go to tomhartmann.com.